Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of EverQuest Old School. And on tonight's episode, I am joined by a really good friend. We have Cypher Deck with us.
Hello everyone, this is Cypher Deck.
And he is playing his wizard, Fever. What level are you now, man?
I'm level 48. He's about to hit 49.
He's booking it through those levels, guys. I mean, last time I saw him, I think he was like 42 or 43, getting ready to go to like a plane, trying to get to 46 as fast as possible, and already way up there now. So it's going to be pretty cool to see. I think
cast.
I think invisibility, yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm just making sure. Yeah, so we're going to probably try Yeti Caves.
Yeah, that's going to be kind of cool. I haven't tried Yeti Caves with this guy yet. I did it with my cleric, but I've never done it with my monk. And to be honest, guys, I haven't really been on very much in the last few weeks, so I'm a little rusty. I'm actually feeling, you know, like I might not know everything I need to know about my character. So hopefully we don't get killed over there, and we can pull these guys solo and kind of take it on. We'll have to ease our way back into it, but thankfully we got Fever here, who at the very least will be able to use evac to get us out of there, but I'm pretty sure he can solo these guys by himself, so probably not going to be too big of a deal.
Yeah, I can probably two or three shot him.
Wow, that's crazy. Wizards are amazing when they don't get resisted. Now, are you finding that you get resisted quite a bit on certain mobs? Are there zones that you just stay away from completely because they're a nightmare? Either they cast on you or they resist a lot?
No, you know, people always tell me you're going to get resisted, or if you go to KC at level 45, you're going to get resisted, or if you're going to go to Chardock at level 45, you're going to get resisted. But I haven't been resisted at all.
That's good, because that's one of the things I was worried about. I never played a wizard all the way to max level, and from what I've seen, pretty much the only experience I had with wizards were in raids. And raids, you know, they're a different beast altogether. And those guys always complain about getting resisted on the mobs we were fighting. But with you saying that you're not getting resisted on the group set, that seems to have a little bit more faith for my little wizard, who's I think only level like 13 or 14, to put a little bit more effort in getting him up, because that would be really cool.
Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with what we're killing and when you start to cast. Like, though there's no research or anything showing it, it feels like if you wait until the mob is below 50%, that they resist a whole lot less.
Right. So. Well, and, you know, on top of that, if you do have other people in your group, there's a good chance by the time he's at 50%, an enchanter or a bard or somebody has cast some sort of lowering his resist down, like a mallow or something along those lines, right?
Right.
Now, do you have anything like that? I believe there's a staff that you can do a quest for that lowers resist.
Yeah. I do have this, and I got that at level 10, I think, and it's clickable at level 20, I believe.
Nice. And that one actually lowers just their elemental resist or all resist?
Fire and ice specifically.
Okay. So you have a good amount of fire and ice spells, to be honest. You don't really get your magical spells, I think, until after 50.
No, you get some beforehand. Like right now I have Force Strike and the level 44 spells, or level 44 main DD was a magic. But now at level 44 was fire, 39 was magic.
Oh, okay. And then I think you get your Ice Comet at 49, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and then after that, believe, and you know, don't hold me to this because I've never played a wizard all the way up there, but I believe you get a magical one against giants and then something against dragons as well, right?
Yep, but it's only apparently works on certain ones. Let's see.
Are you fighting these guys here?
Where are you at?
Inside the tunnel.
Are you behind me?
Yeah, I'm probably pretty far behind you.
Okay. Was there something that spawned?
Oh, just a couple of those guys. I was just wondering if you were killing them, because it looked like somebody was.
Oh, no. It wasn't me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, those two runes right there, I had to turn in the staff I'm using right now. and a gem that you get whenever you whenever you get the staff, and it gives you both of those runes.
Oh, okay.
So I had to redo the staff quest again.
And what do you use those runes for?
To create Ice Comet.
Yeah, I know a lot of people love that one. It does tremendous amounts of damage. Have you ever seen a mob use it on somebody? And we have plenty of videos Thune being hit by it. We went to Charduk. Charduk, it killed all of us. That one night that we were over there, that was just a nightmare because I didn't bind in the right spot. I was an idiot, but... You know, that Ice Comet just one-shots people completely. At like level 50-something, you're getting one-shotted by an Ice Comet. And I believe it does pretty close to the same amount of damage when you cast it, you know, which is not always the case.
Yeah, it's one of those things that once you start fighting mobs that are 49-plus that are wizards, you have a chance to get Ice Cometed.
Right, but I'm just saying, like, it's not always the case where if you see a wizard, which is an enemy, like a Frogluck or whatever, cast a spell, and he does, you know, say, you know, 2,000 points of damage, you having that exact same spell at that exact same level probably won't do the amount of damage he does. But Ice Comet is one of those few spells that you just do tremendous amounts of damage. Like, you can one-shot people with that thing.
And you can see it coming, too. It's just having to get that stun off so that it... so that it doesn't cast it. It's the only ice spell that they'll usually cast.
If you have a stun, otherwise you see it coming and you're just like, I'm dead. You know, like there's nothing you can do about it. You know you don't have enough hit points for it, and nobody has a stun up, and you don't have a stun. There's not much you can do in the way of stopping that. I mean, you can't even feign death after that. Once the mob has started casting his spells, you're locked into it. So yeah, it's a very, very dangerous one. But I love it when wizards have it on our side.
There's a warrior over here. I wanted to see if he was camping him or if he wanted to join us.
He'd be more than welcome to. You know, he's probably camping the outside because I do believe there's a couple that spawn out here. And he's at 50%, so he's probably sitting there, you know, binding wound back up to 50 and then sitting down waiting for the respawn. Be a very slow camp, but, I mean, if he's forward, if he's willing to put the time in.
Yeah, I'm sending him a tell to see if he's doing the inside mobs.
I never really see warriors solo too often. That's not... I mean, I guess if you're at work and you kind of have a little bit of time, every 15, 20 minutes to do something, this wouldn't be that bad of a spot. But if you're a warrior, most likely you're going to be in a group, so...
All right, I'm going to pull to here or at least take a look inside.
You don't want me to go inside? I can pull.
No, I'm just going to take a look because... I just want to see if anyone's camping it. If someone is, then I don't want to take their camp.
Right. I'll go in there with you because I can always feign.
Yeah, that's true.
I just feel weird being left out and as a monk. I'm like, you know, my cleric, he doesn't mind sitting down. But my monk, you know. So
we were having this conversation the other day with Tara. And Noddle, I was trying to tank.
Your wizard?
I was the main puller in the hand room because our puller wouldn't pull.
Wow. You know, it kind of boggles my mind. By the time you get to that level, you don't know your class. But it happens. I've seen people who group with friends the entire time. And then, you know, they, whatever reason the friends aren't on, there's a period of... you know, a couple weeks where they're doing their own thing or whatever the case is, and they have to go out and they have to group with other people, and they don't know their class very well, and I can't really blame them for that. The game is so much better when you have people to spend it with, but at the same time, you do want to get familiar with how to play your guy, especially in groups, and it looks like we're going to have an ad here in a second, because you rooted this guy, right?
Yeah, he's going to turn back.
There we go. I think we can fight him in the cave. I don't think...
I think so, too.
I don't think these guys are going to be too much of a problem.
You get experience? Oh, I did. And he's pulling. Okay.
That's all right. There's more than enough in there for us to share with him.
I'm at 45% mana.
I'm pretty good on life, so I think we can, probably solo these guys.
Let me harvest real quick, and then I'll come in.
All right. Yeah, if you want to just kind of... do one cast or something like that, let me take the hits, because I still have mend and I got a lot of bandages that we can use, so unless we get more than one, I don't think we're gonna have too big of an issue. Let me go ahead and sit down and wait for you to come back in.
Yep, I'm coming.
Now, they do respawn pretty quickly in here, I remember from way back when. So, oh,
very, very fast.
But they're all just dark blue to me, so like I said, I don't think that's going to be too big of an issue. Come on, my little dude.
We'll see how much experience I get. I'm at 67 at the moment.
Yeah, hopefully, you know, what I was doing, and I was getting like 3 to 4 experience per kill. But I don't think it's going to be that high for you at your level, but it should still be somewhat decent.
Yeah.
But if it's not, we can always try somewhere else. I mean, that's the key is, like, if you're in a group with a lot of people, you got to find something that everybody is going to be able to get something out of. Wow, you just completely smacked that guy. How much are you hitting him for?
That was 622.
Oh, my God. That is nuts. That is I love the fact that you can hit him for that much. All right, and I'm full life. What's your mana at?
47.
47.
I only casted one spell that time.
Let's see if I can single pull these guys. Body yeah. Pull it.
It only costs 250 mana.
Wow, these guys have a very low aggro range, huh?
Yeah.
I got one.
It's like trolls.
Oh, we got somebody in here with us. Do they want to join us?
I don't know. I'm trying to see what they want to do.
The more the merrier. How much experience did you get on that kill? Did you look?
I didn't see any experience movement.
Well, then maybe not the best spot. Let's see. I am about 50%, almost exactly 50%, probably 49. Oh, he just gave me Spirit of Wolf. Actually, nice. Gave me quickness. Not much killing for XP.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking to him.
Yep.
Yeah, a little bit less than 1% per kill.
Are you checking the bodies?
No, I was going to leave a couple of loots for you. I mean, I don't want to loot everything.
Yeah.
There's more than enough to go around. So, and the cash here is actually pretty good. But as a monk, I do tend not to loot very much. In fact, I usually play characters that don't loot very much in general, just because, oh, in fact, I forgot
just
how much...
Just because you always have loot on you.
Yeah, and I'm always overweight, and I forgot that I was low on life. All right, we should still be able to do this.
Yeah, I'm gonna two-shot it.
Oh, he's hitting the other guy.
Just because he's close.
Yeah, we got him. Let me sit back down after this one. Wait for my men to get back up. I need to get in the habit of looking at my life. It's not something I normally do with my cleric, so...
All right, go ahead and invite him. See if he wants to join us.
Yeah, toss it in there, man. Ah, there we go. Let's see, what is he? I think he's a shaman, right?
Yeah.
So that works. Let me sit down for a second. Welcome.
I could quad kite these, to be honest. But I think it's better if we do it this way.
Yeah, I mean, just the fact that when you're in a group, you get to meet new people, you get to have a conversation with them. You know, I know I talk about that a lot in my videos, guys, but to be honest, there's nothing better in an MMO than hanging out with people. You're going to find some of them you get along with, some of them you may not, some of them don't talk, and some of them talk way too much, like myself. But either way, if you make a good friend... That is something that you'll cherish for years to come. And, I mean, you played back in the day, right?
Oh, yeah.
You remember any camp in particular that was just really, really fun? Not because the camp itself was challenging, not because it was really all that great of an item, but just because normally the groups tended to last longer because they were harder to get to and things of that sort. And so you had really good and fun experiences with the people more than the area.
I know whenever I did camp, or King in Seb, we usually had some pretty crazy people in those groups where we were just, we had time between the pulls, so we would just chat up a little bit, had hours upon hours in that camp.
Yeah, and people would stay in King for a long period of time too, so.
Oh yeah.
That's a perfect camp.
I think there was one time where we all body camped at least one fungi a piece.
Oh my god!
And we had a full group.
You guys had luck with your loots back in the day. I always had horrible luck. I camped that FBSS for weeks, never got one. I camped the fungi tunic for probably not weeks. I wasn't really too much into getting that one because I didn't have a monk, and those are the ones that really use that one. But
yeah,
I camped that one for a long time. I never even saw one drop for the longest of time. So yeah, I've never had very good luck with those. But yeah, I do like the floor in that room that you can do the little slippity slide kind of, moonwalk on that floor. And you can get that little waterfall and you can be like, I'm swimming. And if you're careful. Oh, we got an extra one behind us. Yeah, we're going to get an ad here in a second.
Okay.
But yeah, if you're careful. Behind us? Yeah, you can see him over there. He just respawned.
I'll just kill him.
Oh, that's all right. He hasn't come over just yet.
I got the mana, I think.
But you could swim around in a circle in that little tiny area, or you could go in front of that a little further into the room, and there's actually a ditch that you jump down there and you could swim around. So I remember people who weren't very high on their swimming skill going in there and just kind of playing around with it and leveling their swimming skill up.
Yep.
All right, let's come back over here and help you out with this. Oh, you got it already.
I'm beast, and now I'm OOM. But
all right, so I got a couple of loots. I'm good for a while. Ah, and he pulled the other one too.
Nice. Shaman's actually a really strong soloer, so
yeah, Super Bits and Bob,
surprise.
Man. Super Bits and Bob, man, he tears it up.
Man, that proc is nice. 300 damage for that proc he's doing.
Yeah. I mean, if you can get that to... Like, he's a shaman, though, so he's going to get that extra dexterity buff all the time. Ah, there it is again. Jeez. That's a tough little sucker right there. Too bad there's not enough guys in here. Like, you really want this wall to come down? It looked like maybe they were going to add something into that area at some point. That's why they left that little indentation, but they never really got back around to putting it in.
This cave's open again. Or has mobs.
Alright, I'll pull it back. If you guys want to sit right there in that little tunnel area. There's going to be some repops there in a minute, too.
Yep. He's following you.
Yeah, I think he's trying to get the pool in. It's all right, we'll fight him in here. His doggy's already going to work on it.
Plus the fact that he can slow. There was a guy in Charis's tonight that had five mobs locked down while he was also dotting them, and also just his health was full the whole time. I don't know if he was an Iksar or not. He was in bear form, but he was just destroying the camp.
See, that's cool though that, a game like this can be challenging for groups, but yet at the same time, if you're skilled enough, you can do the whole solo thing all by yourself and just take it to town, man. You can do amazing things in this game with the right class and the right skill level.
Yep.
Now, do you find yourself able to do things like that with your wizard that maybe you haven't been able to do with other classes?
Yeah, I'm kind of at a standstill though, because I can quad kite. But my next good quad kite spell isn't until level 52, whenever I can start doing 800 damage per mob. So it's right now I can do 230 damage per mob per cast.
Let me give him some food real quick. I brought some extra with me. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of like a Shadow Knight. If you find yourself right in between the level range where you get your new spells and you're right at the old spell limit, you're not doing quite as much damage as you normally do.
Yeah.
But once you get that new line of spells, you just become like OP for the next two levels or something. So it's it's always a great feeling. You want that next, and they make you wait for it. That's the thing, like they don't give it to you too soon, so you're actually drooling over it by the time you get to it. But it's not too big of a wait, I don't think. It's just right most of the time. I think the only ones that's too long is revive for a cleric. You gotta wait like 20 something levels before you finally get yours.
Yeah, I pretty much for me, I'm really wanting my level 40 or level 49 and level 52. 52, I get a new AoE snare and a new quad kite DD. And that quad kite DD will allow me to do Wyvern like it's nothing, and also be able to do Armored Men.
You know, the Armored Men are just insanely tough if you're taking the hits. It's going to be kind of interesting to watch your videos and see how well you can solo them when you don't actually have to take the hits from them.
Yeah, when you can... I watched the Wizard do it, but he was a little bit higher than me. But we don't get another AoE or quad kite spell until level 55, and I think it's our last one. So we'll see how that goes.
Well, I mean, you know, if you get a spell level 55, that should last you till level 60, you know, like that should be good enough even at 60.
But it's odd because the 800 damage turns to 860 damage. They only add 60 damage into the level 55 spell. So it's just kind of weird.
Well, it may not sound like a lot, 60 damage, but 60 damage is more than you had before, and it kind of adds up, doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, I mean, no, well, no, because, I mean, you're gonna, you're, well, let me check. Let me see what the spell is, because I'm pretty sure it does scale up as you go along.
Right. Now, when you're scale up, how much do you normally see that increase? Because with the clerics, you know, buffs, those are supposed to scale up too, but it's pretty small in relation to what you normally get. So, I mean, if it does like 500 hit points for a buff, by the time it scales up, you know, for the next few levels, you might get 520 if you're lucky.
Right.
And so it's not even like something I even bother noticing because it's nothing. But for a wizard, it might be, you know, kind of useful in that regard.
I mean, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's 51. 51 is whenever I get my 800 damage. Let's see. Oh, it's 750 at level 51. 800 at level 60.
751, you said?
755.
755.
And then it goes up to 800.
See, that's actually a pretty nice increase for a damage spell, you know? For a hit point spell, you know, an extra 45, 50 hit points wouldn't really mean a lot, but for damage, that actually adds up.
And then it's... Wait a minute. Is that total? 800 total? I think it's 800 total damage. And then you get to level 54, and it's 848 per mob.
Oh, sweet.
That's a lot of damage if you count that up.
If you do the maximum amount of mobs, I mean, how many mobs can you hit with that? Is it 8? Is it 16?
4.
4?
It's 4. Yeah.
Okay. Well, still, I mean, 4 mobs at the same time, that's hard to manage, but if you can do it, that's some good experience.
Yeah.
I don't know very many groups, even when they have enchanters, bards, clerics, all of the necessary group or people that you need in a group, most of them can't handle 4 mobs at the same time. And if they do, they need a little bit of a break in between before they do the next one. And the fact that you can do all of that by yourself is impressive, to say the least.
Yeah, that's 3,000 damage per cast, if you count it up.
Man, that's nuts. That's good mana efficiency right there. Now, how much does that cost you, though, as far as the spell goes? Is it a lot? Is it like a bubble apiece?
It is 344 mana.
That's not bad. I mean, my resurrection spell costs 700. So, yeah, like, that's doable. My complete heal is 400, so 300? Yeah, that's...
It's the exact same amount as the quad kite at the level 51 spell.
I think a shaman is taking some hits here. He's running all over the place. I don't think he likes getting hit. I'll bind him up here in a second. See if we can task some stuff on him. Where's my bind? I don't know where my bind is. Let's put it on over here. There we go. And he runs away. So maybe we won't bind him. Yeah, I do like wizards. I just, you know, the one downside I always saw to him is the meditation. Like,
oh, yeah. Right now, that's my biggest problem is meditation. If I don't have C2, then I feel like it's taking me days to get mana back.
Right. And, you know, in a fight, I've noticed a lot of time, and, you know, I don't blame the wizards for doing it. You know, they sit there for 90% of the fight. If you're lucky, they cast one spell. If not, they sit there the entire time and do nothing. But when they do show up to the fight, they can kill things in, like, 2 hits. So, you know, it's noticeable when they're not doing anything. And that, I think that's the other downside, is people who don't understand the class are always giving them a hard time. They're like, why didn't you cast anything that fight? You know, what are you doing sitting there all the time? Well, it takes so long for your mana to go back up that unless you do, like you said, have Clarity or Clarity 2. Clarity 2 for sure is just a heaven send for anybody who has to cast spells, whether they're a cleric, an enchanter, a wizard, any of them. It's an amazing thing to have. But if you don't have that, I don't know. I don't know if I could sit there and just kind of watch the fight go on and realize I can't do anything. Like, I gotta wait.
Well, the thing is, though, is that wizards usually have the highest mana in the game. I may be wrong about that. But, I mean, we have a lot of mana, and our spells cost a lot of mana. Right. So, when I cast, I try not to even cast unless my mana is above 50%, just because of the fact that once it gets below 50%, it just feels like it drags on forever.
Well, isn't there something to that, though? I think, like, if you have items on you that increase your intelligence or your wisdom or whatever the case may be for your class, that all is beyond the 50%, so under 50% is your base, and then beyond 50% is your extra, and that's why it seems like once you hit past 50%, it takes forever for you to get anywhere, because that's like a giant amount of your mana pool there.
Yeah, like right now I'm at 38 mana, and I'm at 800 of 2,371. I have 233 intelligence. And most everything I'm wearing has mana on it.
Right. Yeah, you know, I mean, it does even it out. I mean, it is 50% of whatever you have. It's not, you know, like your base mana pool like I was talking about, but it does seem like it is. You know, it has that feel to it. So.
Oh, yeah.
And you definitely want to make sure you got a little bit of a mana pool no matter what class you are, whether you're, you know, a healer or a tank or whatever, just for those emergency situations where things go badly. And you want to make sure, you know, you can step it up whenever you need it to.
Yeah, and a lot of times I don't go below 30% mana. It allows me to throw on a rune. It allows me to, he's getting hurt a little bit.
Yeah, if you want to root this thing so we can back it up. Ah, there it is, 17, 16%. Yeah, he cast a spell in there at the very beginning, and I don't have a taunt, so.
Slow.
Well, I think he's casting a little bit too soon is the thing on that one. Let me bind him up a little bit. But take us through a average fight, like what we're doing right here. What are you normally doing? Do you sit down? Do you wait till 30%, 40%? Do you cast a spell? Like, what spells are you using?
Well, right now what I do is if I'm in KC, I won't even touch the mob until 50% or I have a chance of grabbing aggro. That said, I've been in some really, really good groups lately where there's no chance I could grab aggro if I cast right away. We were in a group today where Bard was kiting around all of LCY, all of the basement, and all of the captain's area in separate pools the whole time. It didn't matter if I casted anything on anything. The slow that she was casting would not allow me to grab aggro.
See, that's cool. I mean, you have seen several warriors too that just happen to have the right weapons that can hold aggro really, really well. So,
and that's with warriors, I won't even cast until 50%.
Yeah.
Especially once I get Ice Comet, it's going to be a huge, huge aggro, and might as well not even think about it.
He pulled aggro again.
Pulling these way out, and he doesn't have to.
I think he's trying to run from him. He's hoping you probably rooted, but
yeah,
or that I can still aggro somehow. But as a monk, I have no options on that one.
Yeah, it's only haste and and I have an ad.
So now that you you wait till 50% before you cast, what spells are you casting? What kind of spells do you have on your arsenal that you switch back and forth depending on the situation?
Like for most of my casting, I use conflagration, which is the 622 damage. If we get to a point where the mob is just so low that if I cast, it's going to be wasted, I'll still throw a ice shock on, which is my level 34 spell, which is 160 damage, and it will. It will allow me to do 320 damage to them.
Right.
Or, yeah. 160 mana, 320 damage.
And that way you don't waste too much if it's not gonna, you know, take it anyways.
Right. And if I need to, if we have a caster, I do have a stun as well.
So you are using two different direct damage spells. You have another stun spell. What do you have in the case where you're fighting mobs that may be resistant to certain things? Like, if you go to Lava Storm, I do know there are a lot of them over there that are resistant to fire. Have you seen that personally, or...?
No. Actually, it's very odd that in Velks, the mobs that I'm fighting usually do better with ice than they do with fire.
Well, I mean, I guess I could see the theory behind it. They're already freezing cold, and then you hit them with an ice spell, you know, like sending them over the edge. But right. Yeah, I mean, I guess I could see what you're saying too, which is they live in a cold environment. They probably shouldn't be susceptible to that.
Yeah, and as far as my my things are going bad spell list, I always have my my rune up. That way I can make sure that I can get out ASAP, or I can take the damage long enough to root the mob and get away from it.
Now, tell us a little bit about your rune, because a rune is not something I am very familiar with. I've never used it on any characters. I think yours is one of the only classes that get it, right? You and the mage, maybe?
Actually, all casters get it, but it's the enchanter who excels in it. So they get what's called an actual rune, but for me, I get different skins, and they don't deflect certain damage the same way, or deflect the amount of damage that an enchanter would. Like, I could probably take 200 damage without getting hurt with my rune. And Chandler could probably negate about 1,000 damage.
He said I need to get an upgrade. In a while.
Only two points. I have something for you.
What's that?
I'm not going to tell you. Just come and get it.
This sounds so bad.
Just come. Let's see. Yep, that's it.
This is that. Ooh, a Woo's Quivering Staff. Nice.
Oh, you didn't want it?
Oh, I already have one.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, yeah. When we were lobbies, somebody ran by and they gave me and Hydros and who was else was there? There was several of us there. I think Chupa might have been there and Dark Dragon and Bushido Bull. Like, somebody ran by and they gave us all really, really good weapons right off the bat.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I got a few, a few of them rotted in some groups that I was in.
I guess that's why they were giving them away.
Yeah. They drop a lot in City of Mist.
Oh, you've been spending time over there?
Yeah, I've been on the second floor a lot.
Yeah, so I haven't been able to videotape that yet. Or yeah, videotape it. We're back in the 80s, guys. I need my Betamax. Pop that sucker out. No, I mean, you know, I haven't been able to go over there and capture any video of that area, so I need to at some point go over there. What level would you suggest doing that?
You can probably start going there now on your mage, but,
My mage?
My mage? Not mage, I mean your monk.
I was gonna say, my mage is only, like, level, I think, 3? I'll try it. I'll take him over there. I don't think he's gonna make it.
Oh. Noise is going on all over the building here. Yeah, I think you could probably go there now, but they usually like 40 plus.
Right. Well, you know, again, that depends on the class too, right?
Yeah, that's true. Takes you right up to that line before KC.
Well, I mean, technically, you could do KC at my level. I've gone to KC and I've killed mobs over there, so. I'm not a huge fan of KC because you spend so much time there as it is. Like, I'm not in a rush to get there because I know once I go, I'm going to be there for a long time. Because it's a great zone. There's a lot of stuff there. But, you know, when you know you're going to be stuck there for a while, you're just kind of like, hey, I'll get there eventually and then I'll enjoy it. Seb, though, I don't know what it is about Seb. I could spend all day, every day in Seb. Pretty much never get tired of it because every single spot you can camp in that room or in that zone has a completely different feel to it.
Yeah.
You know, like you go to ABC. ABC is pretty difficult on its own, and we never really had ABC when I was playing back in the day. ABC was 3 different groups each.
I think Nano was doing that the other day. Where you go back and forth between camps.
Right. See, I should be fine through this fight, yeah.
I don't know why my mana isn't going up so fast. I have enough water, I think.
I can give you some more if you need it.
Yeah, I guess I have two water left.
Oh, I'll give you some more. I have an extra stack. I picked some up before we headed over here. Let's see, what backpack did I put it in?
Oh, and I have one charge of this. It gives you strength and other stuff.
Sweet. Yeah, something I need to buy. I mean, you don't have to if you're in the area. I got the money for it. I just never ever seem to go over there. Is invisibility potions. Need to snag some from the Dark Elf City. I believe somebody said you can buy them from the High Elf City too.
Yep.
But I've never found the vendor for them over there. I looked one day. I just didn't see them.
Whenever you zone into the second half of Felwith, there's a building right when you zone in. You go straight to that building, and there's a mob, or there's an NPC there that will sell them to you.
Oh, okay. This guy probably thinks we're all rude because we're not talking to him very much. If you ever see the videos, man, we're not trying to ignore you. It's just when we get into our conversations. Plus, with me, I got a mic in front of me, and the keyboard is kind of like off to the side. So every time I need to type, I have to move the keyboard back over. And it's not very easy for me to do. I hate the fact that it's not, because when I'm not doing the videos, I am like the chatterbox of the group. I'm just sitting there starting conversations and instigating stuff between people and being like, you know what, you know, mages suck, right? And just seeing like people's reactions, you know, and just I get people talking and then, you know I'm joking, but sometimes it's just too quiet. You know, nobody's saying anything. And you're like, you're playing an MMO, you're sitting in a group, you're going to be there for a few hours. You need that constant, but maybe not constant, but, you know, why not learn who you're with and what kind of crazy people. Some of these people are crazy. You know they are, and you'll find them, and you're just like, well, okay, you know, that's interesting. I'm not sure I would go that far, but, you know. Come on, Yeti, bring it in. You know, he's growing hair in, like, the worst spots and the places that I would think the Yeti.
The Yeti.
And the places I would think you'd want hair the most are the places he has none. He has to be very, very cold on his stomach and his nipples. I mean, that's just doesn't seem like that would be the place. Like, the whole body should be covered.
Oh. Yeah.
He's just, you know, he's the new fashion. He's the 21st century, or is the 22nd century Yeti. He wants to show off his abs. You know, he wants to be loved just like everybody else. But guys, I think we're going to go ahead and call the episode here. I do want to thank you all for coming out and joining us tonight. This has been a little tiny taste of the Yeti Cave. If you've never been over here before, it's really fun. It's usually a really good experience too, depending on your level. And you can stay here for several levels and solo this entire thing. But just remember, there are a lot of people that want this area. So play friendly, play nice, share it. Join groups, do whatever you need to do to make sure people aren't getting too upset about it. You can take like three or four. Sometimes you have like one person inside that cave and one person inside the other cave and another person out here inside the tunnels and even somebody back out there by the entrance. So there's enough to go around. Obviously, if you have more, you can get more experience, but don't be too greedy. Share it and have a good time. Remember, it's the holidays, so be a little bit extra nice to people. And I'm just going to wish you guys a happy Halloween, guys.
Yeah.
For me and, Cypher Deck here. Until next time.
This is Cypher Deck.
And I'm AC Gamer.
Peace out.
Hey, guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.